I'm talking to a brother who's Canadian, doesn't want to give their name. They are about my age. They're a person with a disability. They are on a vacation, and the COVID hit. And this has been, I don't know, quite a few stories I've been hearing about this. People in their trailers, people in their car, families, they're traveling. Boom, they're stuck here. And so this person was able to make it on their own for the time being. And now here they are, April 30th is coming up. And I just asked him, are you willing to just express, how do you feel about the April 30th deadline and the bylaw telling people they have to pack up every day, given Dr. Bonnie's suggestion about everybody stay where they are?
Well, it's frustrating as heck because, sleeping on the ground or setting up a tent every single night at 7 o'clock and having to get up at 6:30 to start tearing it down so it's down by 7, and then wander around for 12 hours waiting for a place to go. I mean, it's the waiting around that drives you insane. And then the province has passed, passed restrictions that we can't go into restaurants. So even I can't even go into a Timmy's and plug my batteries in anymore. I can't use their toilets. The washrooms at gas stations don't exist anymore. I mean, so what am I supposed to do? Wander around? Do I find an alleyway that I can hide behind a dumpster to take a dump? Yeah. I mean, that's, these are all little things that, we're exposed to the elements. So, it's great when it's sunny, but when it's raining, what do? Do you huddle underneath a tarp for hours upon hours on end, waiting for 7 o'clock when we can go and lay out our sleeping bag possibly again? Oh, but then where do we lay the sleeping bag out? In the water, right? On the wet grass?
How do you feel about the CRD is saying that people don't need food anymore out here after the 30th? Red Cedar Cafe wants to keep feeding people. A lot of people we hear about are going to stay out here. How do you feel about that?
Well, there's a serious problem about that. First off, go to a walk or a drive-through without a car. That's an issue right off the bat, right? I says walk in and take out order, right? At what cost? I mean, we don't have that kind of money. I mean, the people that make the rules that determine how much I get for disability make $100,000+ a year, yeah. Right? They don't have to live on $12,000 a year like I do.
So especially if you have to move every day, you're still going to need food until the COVID is over. You're still going to need to be able to survive.
I've got a stove, and I can cook. But I've already been warned twice now by bylaw officers and the parks guys that I can't start my stove, even on a picnic table where it's 100% safe, right? It's a $250 stove, for crying out loud.
And we just heard from people at Howard Johnson that they are saying that people don't have the ability to have an oven in their room. We're just a bunch of little children, and they patronize the heck out of everybody. It's there's a big concern at the Howard Johnson and every other hotel. They threaten to take out all the stoves and the ovens because, God forbid, you don't know how to cook on your own without burning the place down.
Yeah, and, that's an issue. I mean, food is enough as expensive walking into Thrifty's to buy it, right? If you can cook it. So what are we all going to eat? Are we going to all eat garbage food, snack food, chips and stuff that doesn't need cooking?
And they never shut down.
What does that do to the body, right?
Exactly. We need healthy food. Red Cedar gives healthy food. And they can't
Healthy food. And they're like clockwork. It's sitting right there right now ready for me.
And I just want to say, as far as human rights and the rights of poor people, whenever there's a fire in an apartment and there are lots, or in a condo and there are lots, or in a house and there are lots, they don't shut down the whole apartment or the whole condo and tell people, you can't have an oven anymore because one is fucked up. But that's what they do to the poor. Yeah. I just want to say that. And thank you very much, brother. All right. I'm going to stop this for now, but if you want to do another one, let's do it.
That's fine.